old, they said. And with most people, you think yourself, it can't be that long, he looks too young. However, that's not the case here. We have a huge welcome to the man. Come on, Vin Garbutt, come on, yeah!
That's very nice. Right, if anybody's already seen me on this, this 30 years on the road tour, you might have spotted me chronologically. I really learned a lot of old songs, right? I'm going to sing the first song, possibly the first song he ever wrote. Dead simple, listen. And the reason I'm doing it is you've got to put new strings on. I want to put new strings on. They need a hammer in before they do anything sensitive. So I'm going to hammer these now. It's a song called The Land of Three Rivers, and it's just about, I wrote it to try and pinpoint the character of a northeaster tonight. Whether I did it or not, I don't know. Circa 1970. Is in me this afternoon, alright? In the land of three rivers, I'm longing to be. Where the tide wear and sings, make the north roll and sing. I'm a nameless John North from the south of the fourth. In the land of three rivers, I dwell. In the steelworks and pits, I've worked with me mates. Not a bad word against the mountain hell. From Trowbridge to Hull and every town in between, I'm known in them all by the accent of God and friendships of honour and glee. I've got lots of friends, I've touched them not enough. I'm a means to their end wherever a woman gets to the wharf. In the land of three rivers, I'm looking to be. Centuries gone, our ancestral homes were prey to the Romans and Danes. But Ainry and New, Odin did too. The Northeast was no place to gain. They tried to enslave us, but all others failed. While it's failed to save data, they held out the veil. In the land of three rivers, I'd long it to be. Where the time wear and sings, make the North Road say. Soil, the branches of an outstretched hands. When loneliness takes you and down finds your song, if you meet up with John North, you'll not go far along. In the land of three rivers, I'm looking to be. When the time here and say, make the North Road and say. In the land of three rivers, I'm looking to be. When the time here and say, make the North Road and say. Thank you.
it's an ambition of mine to get everybody clapping at, well, no, maybe 80% clapping at Trowbridge. I've been to Trowbridge a few times over the years. And it really is, one of these days I'm gonna do a good set. You know, I can't guarantee it every time, but by the end of my set, I'm hoping to get one song that will do the trick. I mean, so I'd like to finish off with that one. I'm going to ask me to do some more here. And it is a song called The City of Angels. Wherever there's expats, there's folk clubs. And on St. Pat's Night this year, and I did a concert in Borneo. And the Ebam Tribes people found me very interesting. It was even with Ebam. I was the only one in the hall, actually, without the bone through my nose. And they were laughing at me because I looked peculiar. And in fact, there's an expression in Borneo, the wild man of Middlesbrough. I'd never actually heard it before, but apparently it's common. And on the same trip, I played up in Bangkok at a college called the Patana International School. And while I was there, I had a few days off and I went up with some students and some teachers to stay with a Thai author called Pira Sudam. And Pira Sudam lives in a village called Napo and gets loads of royalties for his books. And the area is poverty stricken. It's a rice growing area, but the farmers are suffering because Western companies have bought up tracts of rainforests hundreds of miles away. They've cut down the hardwood trees and it's affecting the local ecology. They replant fast-growing eucalyptus trees and all the rice paddies are salting up and silting up. So a lot of the young lasses from the villages are going to work in the red light districts of Bangkok. And while we were in the village in Napo, this young 17-year-old beautiful girl got out of a taxi that waited for 2 hours with its clock ticking. She'd come back to give her mum and dad some money to stop them starving. And Bangkok means City of Angels. And that's the title of this song. All the visitors come to worship the sea and the sun on the Gulf of Siam, where the coconut palms and their heaven stretched out. Welcome to every far land. And the Thai girl's so nice, around sculptures of ice, dance the dance of a thousand years, while the young man shall lean on the foreigner's knee, seems to mirror the melting with tears. A strong western breeze brought the eucalypt trees and the lumbermen planted and pillaged. In corruption they grew, as the wealth of the few from a bush showed no love to the farmer. be free of the pain and poverty. Postman came. He said this pretty young dame has the beauty to pay off the debtors, but she strives to survive, keep her family alive, weaving silk for the stores in the city. But the stories arrive. Country girls thrived in the bars where the whores are so pretty. So she strayed from his sign. The Pat Pong to dance on the bar and to sleep with the dangers. And they gave her a fee. The virus was free. A gift from the sun-loving stranger. Here's the one. In the 60s, I used to go hitchhiking around Ireland looking for folk songs. My mother's family were Irish, so I was looking for my musical roots. And in the 70s, I went wandering around England, or at least the northeast, looking for my English roots. And there's a legend. There's a bridge over the River Esk, just outside Whitby. There's a village called Glaisdale. North Yorkshire, right? And just outside Glaisdale is a bridge, a stone bridge that was built in the reign of Elizabeth I. And it's called the Beggar's Bridge. It's a pack horse type bridge. And it was built by a fella called Thomas Ferris. Now, Thomas Ferris was a lowly, poor farm labourer. And he fell in love with the daughter of his wealthy landowner called Agnes. Oddly enough, his daughter's name was Colin. Anyway, Thomas Ferris fell in love with, not Agnes actually, and her father disapproved and used to refer to Tom as a beggar. Anyway, as it happened, the Spanish Armada was amassing up the south coast, and Thomas said to Agnes, he said, Agnes, he said, I'm sick of your dad calling me a beggar. He said, I'm going to join the Navy. He says, because there's a lot of Spaniards up the south coast shouting Armada. He says, now I reckon I am. He said, so, he said, I'm going to go to Whitby and sign up. He says, but I'll come back tonight and give you a big hug. He said, I'll wade across the River Esk, give you a big cuddle before I go. He says, if for some reason there's a storm and I can't get over the river, he said, I want you to light a candle in your window. No, he said, I want you to put a candle in your window. That's right, to remind you that I love you. And anyway, he went and signed up with Whitby. And he came back that night, and sure enough, there was a storm. the River Esk was a torrent and he couldn't get over. And he gazed up at Agnes's window on the other side, and it was then that he realised he forgot to tell her to light the candle. But he'd gone along enough, so he had the foresight to take a torch with him, and he could still see the candle, right? Anyway, at that moment he swore that when he came back from defeating the Spanish Armada, he'd build a bridge across the River Esk, so that the river would never get in the way of true love ever again. So he went off. He defeated the Spanish Armada. He was gone for 7 years. He came back rich and famous. He ended up Lord Mayor of Hull. And there's a statue of Thomas Ferris in Hull. And he built Agnes this bridge because he was the bee. Her father thought he was the bee's knees. He was rich, famous, and a hero. So they got married, and he built the Stonebridge, the Beggar's Bridge, over the River Esk as a testimony to his love for Agnes. And it stands to this day. She actually wanted an outside toilet, but he said he was going to sing about that in 400 years' time. If you'd like to join in, and I'll build her a bridge for all lovers to see, as they pass by that way to the Cleveland Sea. And never again will an obstacle be in the form of a stormy Esk river. You can use your own accents for this, by the way. And I'll build you a bridge for all the lovers to say as they pass by that way to the Cleveland Sea.
Seven long years.
There's a child in distress at the front. I'm sure we can help out here. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. Has he stopped? Oh, no, it's me singing it at him crying. Oh, really? Oh, yeah. It's giving rock all down there. Yeah, here's a song called This is a Christmas hit. Called The 40 Thieves. And it was written by a fellow called Dave Evanson from Grimsby. And the 40 Thieves are the Trowbridge, who also own these a fleet of lorries, which is known as the Ghost Train. And the Ghost Train comes into the fish quay in the middle of the night. And the prime fish is filched up into the back of the Ghost Train and disappears into the night. And the Trowbridge get up in the morning and they get paid their bonus based on what's left. And nobody says anything about it because jobs are on the line. Here we go, 40 Thieves. Yeah, they even listen to the lonely lord. And most of the lobbies don't go up and see the blind fish took. Nobody talks about the old ghost train. But the lobbies on the fishing never seen again. We got that? You don't even listen. You can, I tell you what, most of my choruses are interchangeable. If you find one that's easy to sing, just sing it for the next song. All right. You don't even listen, you can only look. Watch the lorries driven up and see the prime fish took. Nobody talks about the old ghost train, but the lorries and the fish are never seen again. Actually, I went into a museum in Nottingham, and apparently their prime fish was the Christian name of Robin Hood's clerical sidekick. I think that's coming. Yeah, they don't even listen, you can only look. And the lorries driven up and see the blind fish took. Nobody talks about the old boat's train, but the lorries and the fish are never seen again. On a fish pontoon, on a night without a moon, the stars look down upon a sleepy town, to where the trawlers glide in upon the tide, to where the numbers stand, cause they've a catch to land. And your Christian life as well, and all those weeks it seemed worse than slavery. But if the trip's been good, you don't mind the sweat and blood. And if that land is fair, then you'll pick up your share. But you can't even listen, you can only talk. And when the lobbies came up and seen the dying fish took, nobody talks about the old ghost train. But the lobbies and the fish are never seen again. A foolish few who protested for the crew. They should have looked away, better had enough to say, for they're not worth again. For the rave of all the men, you'll see them on the streets, see how they drag their face. But you can't even listen, you can only look. And watch the lobbies driven up and see the blind fish took. Nobody talks about the old ghost train, but the lorries and the fish are never seen again. She's ashore, the market's very poor, and the mates in the galley reconciled in his tally on his 50 kids short. 50 kids had run caught, one spirited away before the break of day. There's more than one believes there's a band of 40 thieves, 40 drawn and owners, and they land their owners, and it's measured in lives. The tears of kids and wives have seen their men folk sail to perish in the gale. Never seen again. Then even listen, you can only look. And once the lorries driven up and see the prime fish took, nobody talks
seen again.
Christmas hits of my latest album. Right, I only sung four songs at the workshop this afternoon, but I sold 842 CDs just outside the tent. I'm not boasting or all like that, but it could have gone the other way. You know what I mean? But anyway, at the end of this set, I will be selling CDs. I appreciate that nobody knows me in Trowbridge, so I've got some Bob Geldof CDs. And I can get them cheaper than he can. All right. Here's a song called Waits and Weeps. There's a tragedy in the North Sea, 1988, when Piper Alpha exploded, the oil rig. There's lots of Teessiders working in the oil industry. Lots of them are in the North Sea on the rigs. And I've yet to meet an oil rig worker who likes working out there. They like the money, it's good money, but they'd rather have a job at home, but it's not to be, so they're exiled. And I wrote this song for the widows of the Piper Alpha victims. Just yesterday while resting from the drilling of the oil, a landsman on an ocean rig engaged in honest toil, my thoughts returned to Cleveland and beyond the angry sea. And the face of her who waits and waits, waits and waits for me. I pictured her down by the gare, the children in the June. I thought about first meeting and I hummed her favorite tune. As the ocean hissed, I reminisced on how things used to be. Her who waits and waits and waits, waits and waits for me. We've watched the Wilton sunset when the day was nearly spent. I've walked her home, I've left alone. I've played the thoughtful gent. Now the keeper of my captive heart herself far from free. At home she waits and waits and waits, waits and waits for me. In Westminster, the register of those who are employed lulls laymen into thinking there's much work to be enjoyed. But redundancy or exile was the choice that he offered me. So I brave the gales where ships and whales plow the growling sea. My drilling days are over now, I'm finished with the oil. The landsman in the salt sea spray, far from his native soil. On the deck of Piper Alpha, far from home and amity, I see the face of her who waits, waits and weeps for me. And she who weeps and weeps and weeps, waits no more. Teesside had a minute silence for him the next day. And anyway, Wilfie Mannion turned up at St. Peter's Club at South Bank in Middlesbrough. And it was obvious to him somebody had died, so he took his cap off and stood at the back with everybody. And of course, when the minute was up, he says, "Who's died then?" And they said, "Oh, poor old Wilfie." So I wrote him a little tune called Wilfie Mannion's Jig. These are all Christmas hits, these, on the latest album. Philosophy. It's a peculiar little ditty called When the Tide Turns. It was written in 1979-1980. And I've been reading a lot about world overpopulation, but I've been staying in the homes of loads of people. It's part of the job, so you stay in people's homes. And loads of people who couldn't have kids. I knew lots and lots of people who couldn't have kids, but I was reading nothing about fertility problems, just overpopulation. And then I was in North America in 1979 and I saw this stuffed pigeon, a passenger pigeon. Last century there was countless millions of these passenger pigeons and they were a big pest hitting all the crops, so the government put a bounty on them and a lot of them actually crashed because of the weight of the chocolate. But it did the trick. It did the trick, it reduced the numbers. Now they had a nationwide hunt, they just shot as many as they could. And when the numbers were reduced from countless millions to a few hundred thousands, they stopped shooting them. But they ceased to breed, the passenger bred no more. You think they would have done with a few hundred thousand flying about, but they never. As though the species itself suffered some sort of trauma. And the last passenger pigeon died in a Milwaukee zoo in 1913. Anyway, it worried me. I wrote this little song, and the theme being that if you mess about with nature, it's no use apologising later. You have to cope with the consequences. You've already set things in motion. When the tide turns, a black priest will come. When the tide turns to England, my home. When the tide turns, a new rising sun, like a bright flame will burn when the tide turns. And the black priest is symbolic of the poor countries giving the rich countries an injection of the wisdom and the simplicity and the spirituality that we've misplaced for a bit. Trowbridge accepted, of course. When the tide turns, a black priest will come. When the tide turns to England, my home. When the tide turns, a new rising sun, like a bright flame will burn. When the tide turns. Sophisticated men wailed, calling him a fool, saying you'll topple over. The top brains of his day said that can't be the way. You know the world is flat, think on that foolish rover. Reducing our numbers. But when the tide turns, the black priest will come. When the tide turns to England, my own. When the tide turns, a new rising sun, like a bright flame will burn. When the tide turns. Sophistication can kill nations quite as much as starvation. See it in the eyes, hear the cries of the West's depressed. For the weak we leave no room, now the womb is a tomb. Tomorrow's world must die, the mighty say it's for best. For the box was a tie. For the box was a tie. When these paper the vine coexisted one with the fauna and fields. Where Mother Nature gives breath to the soil with each death. A simple symbiosis produces her yield. And when the tide turns, a black priest will come. When the tide turns to England, my home. When the tide turns, Thanks very much. Well, I think that was, I think I miscalculated that. I think that was my last one. So before you decide that, fair enough, I'll do another one. Hey, I'll do another one, don't worry, honey.
You again.
Right, there's an important notice to be announced.
If there's Keith Dunn or Paul Waddington here, could they go to the St John's Ambulance bit? And if Raquel Welsh is here, can she tell us? So if they could... Sorry, it's rather presumptuous, if you don't mind me saying something. That was your last number.
Watch. I thought, oh, plenty of time. By the time I finished that song, guys, my time was up. Here. Oh, I'll tell you what. Here. I'll finish off with one that's the same tune as the last two. Because I saw you relaxing by the time. You know, I went through the second one. I thought, it was familiar, wasn't it? It was a familiar feel. Well, here's another one, the same tune. And it's called The Troubles of Aaron. Right, this is it's a good finisher. This is a good finisher for my last Trowbridge festival of the 20th century. Me and my wife Pat, and the kids went to Ireland in 1994 when the first IRA ceasefire was announced. And we got a cheap ferry crossing, a bucket shop job, exceptionally cheap, from Holyhead to Stranraer. It was false economy, of course, because then we had to get to Ireland. But anyway, while we were over there, as I said, the IRA ceasefire was announced, and the feeling of hope and optimism was just fantastic. Of course, the peace process had a little setback a week or so back. And let's hope and pray it's not the end. Troubles of Aaron, here we go. May the troubles of Aaron be over. May the bulwark of peace be preserved. Civil rights marches were battered with clubs to the ground, and a very fast squaddies lay down his body and part with his soul for the crown. May the troubles of Aaron be over.
His hand.
till the killer will cut his girl down. May the troubles of Erin be over. May the bauble of peace be preserved. May the white dove inspire the children of Ireland. Peace is the least they deserve. The boys in the bar, though, with points past, good friends who could see no divide. A cold, heinous crime took them in their prime. Their blood was as one where they died. Oh, the prisons are filled with their number. The shame, but the wire must come down in each counting down for the ghosts on the past to be laid. So let's pray for the day of forgiveness when the weeping and wailing will cease. And may love
concession table will be out there somewhere. Big plush thing. Whatever it is. We'll have a bit of Roadie's Cabaret for a little while and we'll be back with ASAP. Over to the Muzak. Is it here?